Good afternoon to all. This is Rahita Sveda from School of Mechatronics. I welcome all of you for the expert session on 3D printing technology by Dr. Amar Pathak. As we know that the 3D printing technology is going to affect our day-to-day life and manufacturing industry to a large extent. So, recognizing its importance, School of Mechatronics welcomes all of you for the expert session on 3D printing technology by Dr. Amar Pathak. He has received his doctorate in mechanical engineering from IIT Bombay. He has worked with Mahindra Engineering and Siemens PLM Software. Presently, he is shouldering multiple responsibilities. He is a technical director with iInvent Lab, managing partner with AMP Engineering Design Ventures, and consultant with a Norway-based company. So, with this short introduction, I request Dr. Amar Pathak to take over the session. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Madam, I would like to thank you, college, and all the students for attending this particular seminar on the 3D printing. So thanks all the students also for joining the meeting. And let me start the webinar and let me turn off the video so that we'll get the good buffering speed. And if you have any questions there, we can take it up at the end of the session. So let me share the screen with you. Can you see the screen? Is it visible to all?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, thank you. So as I'm here to talk about the 3D printing, and just to share with you that the 3D printing also goes hand in hand with the product design. So as a quick agenda wise is concerned, we'll quickly talk about the need of the industry, then the product design. I'll not go into much depth of that, but with respect to the 3D printing, what is required, that we'll discuss for the 10 minutes. We'll see some of the videos also, which are the parts which we have designed there. Then we'll look at the 3D printing into the medical and automotive domain. And then we'll quickly look at the academics or the research area wise is concerned. So the session will end after 45 minutes. So roughly about 35 minutes of the discussion, and then last 5 to 10 minutes we'll keep it for the question answer. So, and if you have any questions there on any specific slide, I'll request all of you to note down that particular slide number, and then we can take it ahead. So, and feel free to ask any questions if it is there. So as a 3D printing, to share with you that I'll assume that all of you are not much aware of the 3D printing. But as a basics wise, you know that there is a different processes are there. One is the SLS is there, which is selective laser sintering is there. Then SLA is there. Then FDM is there. So, and along with that, there is a metal printing is there. So there are a couple of different standard processes are there, which are used in the 3D printing industry. So 3D printing has evolved over the last decade. And in the coming future also, it will still there for next 20 years. So that's what I can say that based on what our industrial experience is there in India and abroad. So specifically the medical domain is picking up a lot. So we'll see some of the case studies, and which we are not directly related to it. As all of us, we have come to the engineering background there. So very few of them might have opted for the biology as a subject in the 12th standard. So, and as we have an inclination towards engineering, but in the medical engineering or in the medical domain also, we use the 3D printing frequently, and we'll look at some of the slides. So you'll, and I'm sure that you'll have the liking and some understanding in that area. Second one is the automotive, which is a fairly good interest of almost all the engineers. Then manufacturing domain is there. And the last one we'll look at as academia, wherein which if you want to do something as a postgrad, and if you want to do the PhD there in the area of 3D printing, so those particular slide we'll see in detail. So as a quickly, if you can see this particular model, so this is a Sonalika tractor to share with you. and you can see the arrows there. So this particular arrows are pointing towards the tyroid end. So tyroid end is the component which is connected to the wheel hub, and wheel hub is connected to the wheel, and it is used for the steering mechanism. So when you try to steer the vehicle, so in the automotive domain, there is an angle of steering is defined. So angle of steering can go maximum till 40 or 42 on paper. In actual realistic way, it has some limitations with respect to the vehicle and with respect to the its top speed and the cornering radius. So now how this is related to a product design and 3D printing, that we'll look at it from the further slides. So I'll say that quickly, let us look at this particular small video and you will have some idea. So this is a part what we have designed and how it is abusively used in the industry that you can see. So this particular is the Sonalika tractor is there with the model, and there is a, on the right side, there is a valley is there, and this is at the top of the mountain, and there is a dead weight is there at the front. Dead weight is not necessarily it has to be a weight, it can be a people also. So the each person is assumed to be, as per the ARAI standard, is 75 kg. So there are norms are there. There is a back end, there is a load is there. And you can see that how the tractor is moved, or it is going up the hill. So, and you can imagine the amount of forces and moments which are coming on the steering. And even if you see that, the driver cannot see what, where is the front, because people are standing in the front of him and sitting rather. And why they are sitting in the front is because they want to balance the load. So some people are also walking on the street on the left hand side, and they are also trying to balance the back load. So this is how the engineering is used in actual industry. So, and we need to design the system for that. And the common thought we have is the 3D printing means it's only a plastic, but then answer is no, it is beyond that also. So there's a metal 3D printing is also there. So, and you can see that in further slides. Let me take it little bit ahead, and you can see that the steering is carried out at the right side here. So wherein which the cornering is taking place. And always remember that when you try to do the cornering at that particular point, this is the steering angle, and wherein which our part comes into the picture. So for the designing of the tyroid end is concerned. So it's a one of the only simple part, I'll say that, which you need to look at it in terms of design. But other than that also, there are a couple of parts are there. So this is a common video. Now I'll say that now if you look at this particular tractor tyroid end, you can see that there is a assembly and which we need to design. Now in actual reality, how the process is carried out is, so this is called as a RFQ, which is called as a requirement for the quotation. So this I have learned it when I really started in the manufacturing industry. So it's this particular part which we have seen that goes into automotive, then the manufacturing, as well as in the 3D printing. So all engineering aspects are required there. So first is the vehicle data. So vehicle data indicates the what is wheelbase, wheel trace, CG, dead load, everything. All those information is written. So it's around 400 pages document is there. Then in the fourth year of engineering, we study the designs. So in the third year and in the second year of engineering, we study something as a kinematics of machines, then where in which we use the TOM, then what is the frequency, harmonic frequency is there. And we also study the different concepts like Laplace transform, fast Fourier series. So, and at the time of engineering, we only think that what is the use of this? But trust me, when you really work into the industry, you will come to know that what is the use of this, all this transfer functions and how it is to be taken care of, which is most important. So I'll not talk about that much, but once you get the values of the forces and moments inside of this ADAM software, then you need to make the CAD model, then do the EFI, and finally you need to make the prototype. So this is a one of the ADAMS model, and wherein we need to simulate the data. And once you simulate this particular data in actual reality, then after that you get the value of the forces. So these are the virtual values, and a lot of benchmarking and validation is carried out. And once you get this particular data, then you need to make the model. Now this is actual realistic 1:1 case model, which is of the tyroid end, which we have seen, and wherein which there is a draft is there, then this particular socket is there. Now this particular socket can be machined or it can be 3D printed in metal printing. But if you try to do the metal printing there, it's costly. So instead of that, there is a lubrication material is there. So most of us, we think that lubrication material is always a grease, but that is not the true thing. So there is a plastic inner is also there. And this particular plastic inners are always 3D printed initially at the time of taking a trials, initial trials. And so 3D printing technology is used for the product design at the initial level so that the manufacturer need not invest into the molding. So in the engineering, later once you complete your engineering, then later on you will also study something called the plastic injection molding. So for the theoretical purpose also, we have some gate design is there. So wherein which gate, PRUI, so some sort of designs we study at the initial primitive level. But when you really complete the engineering, you will come to know what is the requirement of the industry. So some of the 3D printed parts are used here. So there is a metal printing, there is something called as a plastic printing, and then is a machining is there. So, and once this particular product is designed, then it is used in the actual industry. So this was an example of the one of the automotive domain. I will look at the medical industry. So how the medical industry works. So all of us, we have already heard about the CT scans and the MRI. So which is nothing but the first image, which you can see at the in this particular slide. So once this MRI and CT is there, then after that, we convert that into the point cloud data. So the point cloud data is nothing but the STL files. And as all of you are aware of that, and if not, then remember that when you want to do the 3D printing, so for the 3D printing of what? So you need to 3D print a part or an object. Now this particular object should have some file format. So that particular widely used file format is the STL. So which is called the stereolithography format. Similarly, when we create the Word file, we keep an extension as a .doc, which is a DOC, which is a Microsoft has kept the registration for that. Similarly, when we create the STL file, which is a point cloud data, it has an extension of .stl. So a part which you model it, it has to have the STL format, because that is a widely recognized format for the all the industries which are doing a 3D printing. And this particular process is also called the reverse engineering. And once you do that, then we need to convert that 3D printed into the solid, or it can be a surface, which is nothing but IGS, it's a neutral file format, and take that file for the simulation purpose if required. So as a process wise, in a 3D printing, in the medical domain is widely used because it helps the surgeons in taking the trials better. So they need not do the trial and error on the patient. So they do the simulations in advance and then take it ahead. The commonly asked question to me is that, in the 3D printing technology is concerned, should I follow the service or should I follow the product design? I'll say that both the fields are very good. You need to decide and make some choice. So not necessarily that everybody should be good in programming. Everybody need not be very good in the design. But in that case, they can opt for the service industry there. But it's very difficult to enter into a medical industry at the starting point is concerned. So some of the quick examples I can say that you can see there is a lung model is there, which is on the left hand side. So as all of us, we are reading in the paper that there is a, because of COVID-19 or because of the coronavirus, it affects the lungs. And some of the cases, we also get it for the modeling and the simulation, wherein which the entire lung DICOM data we get. And based on that DICOM data, we create a path, which you can see on the right hand side. So once we get that particular path, then after that, when any person or any patient inhale the airflow inside, or when they inhale the drug inside, so drug means any paracetamol or some liquid, in that case it needs to follow some path. So that particular following of the path, and we need to simulate and get the some of the results. So you can see that the model has been taken, which you can see on the screen, and from the top there's a fluid is coming inside, so and there's a velocity flow is there. So as a engineers is concerned, either we are interested into pressure, or we are interested into flow, or there is an interest in with respect to that, the molecular level, how it converts. So this is a completely interdisciplinary course there, wherein which we need to convert the model as a STL file. Then after that, do the simulation. You need not do the printing. And this particular veins, whenever you breathe in and breathe out, at that particular point, it really compresses and elongates. So that also aspect is there that we need to consider and remember. So there is a lot of calculations are also involved into this. So there is something called the isosurface is there, and there is a steel geometry is there. So here in this case, you can see that the fluid is there, which is taken inside from the top. So it can be air or it can be a liquid. Sometimes it's a combination of the multi fluid is there, wherein there is a air plus liquid is there. So to tell you that that multi physics area, we don't work on it. We don't know that, but we really work into a single phase of area. Some of you can consider this under the CFD also as a domain, as a computational fluid dynamics is concerned. So there is a interdisciplinary courses are there which comes, but this analysis is used by drug industry. So drug manufacturing industry to take the judgment of how the molecules will flow. So this I wanted to show as a one of the quick example is concerned to get an idea about the medical domain with respect to the fluid flow is concerned. So this is a case one. We'll see a couple of cases. The second one is interesting case is the brain tumor. So always remember that whenever the surgeon or the neurosurgeon wants to operate for the patient having a brain tumor or surgery, at that point, nobody is operated at the instant. So it needs to process. So through the go through the process. So there is a CT files are there. Then you can see that here at the center, there is some deformation is there. So that deformation is tumor. So that tumor we need to identify, which you can see on the right hand side. So as an engineering person, we are interested in the dimensions of that. But how the doctors are interested in the dimensions is because whenever the cut section is carried out of the skull, at that point, the doctor, they really need to understand that and they need to keep that patient open in the operation theater where in which the skull portion is cut. So they need to really think of how much amount of blood do I need to supply, what amount of extra oxygen do I need to keep, whether the patient, if at all, if I give the anesthesia to the patient, which obviously the case, so how long that anesthesia will stay long, can I do the toolpath planning to remove this. So what they do is they scoop out this portion, which we'll see in the further slides. They scoop out the tumor but get it 3D printed, and on the 3D printed model they do the trials of the surgery in advance. So this particular kind of thing is carried out in the most of the hospitals nowadays. Some of them, as a Saifi hospital is there, which is a very good hospital, then Leelavati is there, then Nanavati is there. So some of the couple of hospitals are there in Mumbai where in which we are associated. So, and even at the AIIMS hospital at the Delhi, where in which the surgeons do the surgery in advance. So this is another case where in which there are multiple tumors are there and which needs to be operated. So it is very difficult. And this is a 3D printed, this is a CAD model. Actually, this is a CAD model what we have created. So now we can see that some of the good interesting case study we can see. So there is a chest tumor is there, which you can see the size of the tumor, which is huge. And this is a CAD model what we have created. And now you can see that the actual working of it. So there is a patient is there. So CT scanning has been carried out. So once this particular CT scan is carried out, then there is a skin model is there. So we are showing the rotations of that just to understand the skin. Then we removed the first part. Then you can see that there is an intestine is there. There is a tumor is there. There is a frontal bone is there. Then there is a D1, D2, D12, or all the central bone system is there. And at the back, there is a hip bone is there. So on so forth. But our interest should be only for the tumor in which we are interested. So this is red portion is the tumor. So now this particular tumor is with respect to the WCS, which is called as a world coordinate system. So world coordinate system means it's the coordinate system at which the patient is kept. And with respect to that, we need to identify this particular area. And now this tumor, it's so tough that if some portion of that goes into the heart and if the doctor removes it by mistake, the patient is dead on the spot. So we need to scoop out only this particular tumor, which you can see on the screen, and the volume of that which is to be measured. And accordingly, the doctor will have to arrange for the blood. And they need to really check because of once we remove the tumor, is there any other veins are getting cut? So that is a more interesting part. So the doctors and surgeons are using a 3D printing technology into extracting the tumor. Tumor is only one example which I have given you. There are so many organs are there in the entire body. So the doctors and surgeons, they work on it to work on it, make the 3D model and do the analysis in advance, and then they take it ahead. And some of the in the heart surgery also, it is quite useful. So some of the 3D printed models I'll show you here. So these are the models which we have printed in the past. So the process which we have adopted is the SLS process. That is, the powder is there, the nylon powder is there, and which is sintered. These models are really expensive, but the patient who is undergoing the surgery, for him the life is more important than that of the 3D printed models. So the doctors, they print this particular model, do the surgery in advance. So one day before the patient is operated, one day before or 2 days before, they operate on these plastic models so that they are trained. And once the training is carried out on these hypothetical models, then after that the actual operations takes place. So this is just to show you the power of 3D printing, which is used. So it is not only visualization, it is going beyond that for the actual usage. It also depends on how you want to use it. So some of the in the US, we are working with some company called the Stryker, which they make the stents. So they build the custom built stents so that they manufacture. So some of the prosthetic bones are there, and there's the maxillofacial surgeries are there, where in which we need to design the bone. Now this particular bone is made up of the, it's an implant. So it has involves the CAD geometry, scanning, and then manipulating the data, getting the shape. If required, then do the FEA and simulations of that for the strength criteria, and so on and so forth. So a lot of engineering is involved. So it is not just, see, only I'll say that the simplest task is to do the 3D printing as a service. But before that 3D printing, a lot of things has to be done at the background, which all the technicians, they really do. So I appreciate their efforts and creating a CAD model and converting into the program and take the slices of that. So these are the some of the medical parts where in which the 3D printing is popularly used. So because this part you cannot standardize. So if you know that for the knee surgeries, so some of the your relatives or uncles or parents having an age of more than 70 plus, and those who are facing a knee problem, so they do the knee implant. So where in which they, those are the standard shapes and sizes, where in which there is a standard shape is there, just buy it up and install it. It's a tough job, but where in which there is a orthopedic surgeons and a mechanical engineers, they work together there to get it done. But along with that, if it, the someone else wants to make it custom built, then in that case the implants are carried out. So as I've told you that the 3D printing is used in the medical industry, and it helps the surgeons in taking the decisions, and then for the drug manufacturing companies to predict the behavior of the drug, which we have seen the simulations. So basically the objective is to minimize the clinical trials and save the life. So that is a major objective. Now some of the interesting cases of the are into automotive. So you can see that there is a central chair is there. Now whenever we travel from one location to the another location, there are different ways by which we can travel, and where in which you need to support your back plus seat. So when you need to support your back as well as the seat, at that point everybody expects the good cushioning. So for the cushioning means there is a damping is required. As there is a damping is required, in engineering terminology, we have studied something called as a underdamped, overdamped system, critically damped systems, which I'm sure that with the transition curves are there. So everything you have seen and studied. So all those engineering aspects are important when you really want to design the damping of the chair. So it's a simple system is there. So for in which there are holes are there, somewhere else there is a pockets are there. So there are two ways by which, so it is not just by design, it is not just by arbitrary, it is by design. So nobody does the printing as if they want to make it. So where in which all engineering aspects and calculations are carried out at the behind it, so that the part can be 3D printed and taken it ahead. So this was one of for the international company where in which we 3D printed the seat. The trials were carried out with the cushioning effect, and then finally it was converted into the realistic design with the cushion, actual cushion of the leather plus sponge plus cotton. So that was a project. But if someone else said that, why don't you do it at the initially itself, why the sponge and cotton? Always remember that it's expensive to take the trial, because the trials needs to be taken up and it should be scientifically proven. So for that this particular 3D printing is used. So some of the quick example is that in the auto industry is that aero hat. So if just remember this particular figure, and when you walk on the street, if you go outside, because right now you might not be in a position to go outside, but you can see that the trucks and the small containers are there, which are moving on the road and expressway. They have the some structure like this at the top above the cabin. So this it's specifically used to reduce the drag. Now this particular drag reduction is there, which internally saves the fuel economy. And for the fuel economy, the shapes has to be designed. So this particular shapes are initially 3D printed, and then the engineering is carried out, and finally for mass production, it is printed into the sheet. So sheet has also different grades and sizes are there. So that particular point, this particular point you remember. So some of the our international clients are there, wherein which it's a Voltia is one of the company, wherein which they custom build the cars. So for the custom build of the cars, they modify the shape. And once they modify the shape, they need to make it 3D printed. So the commonly used topic is they do the use a carbon fiber for the mass production. But before they take a decision of the mass production, before that, they need to make the part in 3D printed, take the trials. So for the trial purpose, this particular part is of huge dimensions. It is of 2 meter by 1.2 meter. So 2 meter by 1.2 meter is the machines are not available. So I'm sure that you all of you might have seen the machines of 3D printing. I'm not talking of FDM, but you can see for the SLS or SLA machines are concerned. And if not in the time of curriculum, but at least by the, after your engineering is over, you can see those particular machines. So there is a limitations of the size is there. So, and when you cut the part there, it loses its strength. So we need to take care of the strength criteria also there. So the part is getting fabricated, and then once the part is proven, then it can be printed by using the sheet metal, or it can be manufactured by using the carbon fiber to reduce the weight, but it's expensive. Finally, the manufacturer will look at the cost. So cost is one of the angle which we need to take care of in actual production is concerned. Then how the reverse engineering or the printing is carried out. So first is on right side, you can see that there is a blue light scanner is there, or there is a white light scanner is there. I have as a request to the senior members who is attending this particular sessions, for them the management can buy out this particular blue light scanner or white light scanners which are available. And there is a turntable is there, so wherein is on the top of that the object is kept. So either the table is rotating or the camera is rotating, and the part is scanned. So the part is scanned means it is converted into point cloud data. The point cloud data means it is converted into STL file. And once you have this particular STL file, only after that you can do the 3D printing of the same. So this particular is the benchmarking and scanning activity. And why this is followed is because, see, in India, a lot of parts are imported from outside countries. I'll not say that only from the neighboring countries. It is across the globe the parts are imported. So wherein which the once the part is imported, then we need to indigenize that and convert it into the own models. So if the drawings are shared, then it is very good. But if the drawings are not shared, in that particular case, we need to create our own 3D model. So for that, this scanners are used. So you make the model. And once you make this particular scan data, then after that, on the top of that, you create the geometry, the splines and B-spline curves are there, and you make the CAD model. So CAD model is of the assembly. It's an assembly part is there. So some of the parts are also, we work into the nonlinear analysis of the rubber parts. So we can show you that. So wherein which these are the shapes of the rubber geometry is there. And on the top of that, there is a bracket is there. So we need to do the FEA simulations. So FEA simulations are carried out to predict the nonlinear behavior. In the first year engineering in mechanics, we have studied something called the stress versus strain curves are there. And in the design also, we study as a final year engineering students, we study that there is a stress versus strain curves is there, and wherein it needs to cross, it need not cross the plastic area or plastic deformation. So wherein which when you look at the rubber geometry is there, it is always into the plastic domain, and which needs to regain its own shape once the loading is removed. So such type of analysis needs to be carried out, but nobody can directly manufacture this part. So for the central part, initially you will have to print with the 3D printing. So some of the examples are there with respect to the bracket design is concerned. Now this particular brackets are also 3D printed initially, but always remember that when you use the metal printing, it's 5 times expensive than that of the actual machining process is concerned. So this point you remember. Then some of the quick examples I want to share with you that most of you have seen the two wheelers and you are driving also the two wheelers for across from going from one place to the another or going to the colleges or coming to the or for the commuting. And these are the fuel tanks are there, and this particular fuel tanks we need to scan because we need to do the strength analysis. Or even if you want to modify our two wheeler or bikes, in that case this particular geometry is required. So you need to scan it, convert into the IGS file, take it ahead for the further mass production is concerned. Some of the examples are also used in the toys. So toys is popularly used the industry wherein which we need to do the 3D printing, and for the 3D printing of the area is concerned. So the toys are scanned, and once this is scanned, and then we need to do the printing. And before that, we can do the printing, and before that, the required step is the IGS. So and the mold is carried out. So we have seen that in the automotive industry also it has a use. Plastic industry, toys it has a use. Sheet metal industry wherein which the 3D printing is required. Medical industry we have already seen. Now some of the interesting part is that you can see on the left hand side there is a murti or the statue of Buddha is there. So Buddha murti or face is there. Now this face is made up of the marble. Even on the right hand side there is a at the Venice there is a statues are there. Now all the this is called as a sculptured manufacturing. So how this particular process and industry is growing is that if you want to make the identical statue, then for the identical statue it is very difficult because all the artisans, whosoever is making the models, it purely depends on its skill sets is concerned. So what is the technology is followed and in the industry is that you do the scanning of that statue or sculpture. It is called as a sculpture. Once you do the scanning, convert into STL file. Now once that STL file is created, you create the IGS file, which is IGS is a, why I say that IGS, it's a CAD neutral format. If you are aware of the SolidWorks software or NX software, or CATIA software, which are the commercial CAD softwares are there, wherein which you need to create the neutral format file. And once you get the neutral format file, that file is used by the robot programs. And robots are used to manufacture this particular murtis or statues so that you get the idealistic part. And these are nothing but required for the mass manufacturing. So how the 3D printing is related to that? The 3D printing is initially carried out for the tool path planning is concerned. So how the path of that particular machine or robot will move. So for that it is used. So this is called as a commercial uses of the 3D printing technology. Then some of the idols are also kept there. It is on the same line. So now right hand side murti, if you can see, it's a made up of Lord Shiva. It is 5.5 feet statue is there. And it is cut into two parts and then it is joined. But as it's a marble piece is there, so you need to keep a very high RPM but very low feed rate is required. So these are the some of the parts there. Now another one is a commonly used example is there as a toothbrush. So for the toothbrush, every one of us, we are using it in the morning as well as at the night. So if the dye is available in that case, we can use the dye and do the printing. But once the manufacturing of that dye is taken up over the period, the dye is worn out. And once the dye is worn out, then we need to again make the printing. So we need a printing. We need a printing means we need a physical plastic parts. So if that physical plastic part is not available, in that particular case, it's difficult. So what they do is, the molders, what they do is, they scan the dye, which is on the left-hand side. They scan the dye. Dye, or it is also called as a mold, depends upon whether it is a core and cavity is concerned. Inside of that, they worn out part, they filled up with the welding and then again do the machining of that. So once the machining is carried out, then your piece is fabricated. So these were the few applications are there wherein which we can use the 3D printing in the actual industry is concerned. So now for the some of the parts are there in the academia is concerned, those who have a really interest into doing the postgrad studies, some of you are already planning to do the MS, or some of you have already thought of doing the PhD into 3D printing area, it's huge. Only thing is you need to select the proper area of research and straight away sign up for the colleges and take it ahead. So one is the orientation of the part. The people are doing the research on that for years together. So for last entire decade, people have done the research, and in further decades also they will do that. So orientation of the part really matters the quality of the part, which is called the staircase effect. In single line, I want to say that if the instead of having the part in a straight line, manufacturing it in a straight line, if we make it in a horizontal, in that particular case, the quality of the part is tampered. So quality of the part is very important. Yeah. So that is called the staircase effect. And for that, we need called as a orientation of the part. The second one is the part strength. So for the part strength is important. And because the part which we have fabricated, it should work and it should function. So for that, we need a part strength. And the last one is the hollowing of the part. Why the hollowing of the part is, because when you fabricate the part, it needs to consume the material, and as it consumes the material, it has a impact on the cost, and we need to save the cost also. So there are a lot of researches are carried out in the industry, so and even in the academia is concerned. So those who are really interested into that, please consider one of the aspect of the 3D printing or the 3D printing technology is concerned for the your further graduate studies. So with this, I'll end my webinar. And I think I've completed within 40 minutes as we had decided. So if you have any questions on that, please let me know, and I'm glad to answer them. Yeah, over to you.
Yeah, students, now the session is open for your question answer. So those, if you are having any question, you can directly ask or you can type it in the chat box. Yes, students, if you are having any questions, you can directly ask or you type it in a question chat box.
Good evening, sir. I'm Darshan Gavare from Mechatronics first year.
Yeah. Hi, Darshan.
I have a question. What are the scopes in the automation field for the designing purposes?
Automation. Do you want to say about the automation in 3D printing? Do you want to say that? Or in general?
In general, like what are the scopes for the automation and mechatronics field?
Yeah, see, automation, this itself word is really interesting. I'll say that, see, as a automation also has a lot of variants. So one is that automation works in the packaging. Automation works in the programming. Automation means what you want to do, the precision wise you want to complete the job, and wherein which you don't need a human intervention. So. As a automation wise, the scope is very good and very large. Only thing is that in the automation also, you'll have to also think whether do you want to go with the software side or whether you want to go towards the hardware side. That is also important. So accordingly, and you can take a decision.
Okay. Okay. Yes. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. There is one question from Jyotiraditya. Which is the printing material used in medical applications?
If it is just for the viewing purpose, or if it is not inserted into the body, in that case it is nylon 66, or to which it is also called as a PA 66 material. But if it is to be inserted inside of the body of the human being, then it must be into a titanium, because the titanium is the only material with the grade which human body can absorb and work together. Otherwise, the body will not accept that as a foreign particle. So answer is PA66 is the material which is used for the 3D printing of the medical parts, and if it is to be inserted into the body as an implant, then it is titanium.
Yes, any other question, students?
Yeah. Good afternoon, sir. This is Ishan. I'm final year automobile student. I have question regarding waterproofing issue, because I came across a problem that we design enclosures for PCBs and for other purpose, but the waterproofing is the main problem in case of 3D printing. So how can it be solved?
Yeah, so I think your question is really good. See, because as the 3D printing is porous material, so it needs to be powder coated later on, and there is a coating is applied on the top of that. So once you do the 3D printing of the part, after that you need to do the coating with the waterproof material. So there is a layer, one more layer is formed on the top of that. It is similar to the paint what we apply on our walls.
Yes,
similar
sir.
Kind of coating you need to apply. Yeah. But still it has a limitation. You cannot do the waterproofing for a long. It has a life. Certain life is there. So after two or three units, then after that, it is of no use.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. Yes, sir. One more question from Adnan. Yes. I think he's from first year mechatronics. Okay. How 3D printing is used for detection of cancer? Do we use the 3D printing technology for detection of?
No. Just to answer, 3D printing is not used for the detection of cancer.
No.
It is not.
Yes.
So to answer it out that, see, the cancer is nothing but cancer is the unwanted extra growth of the cells is there. So and that forms some foreign body to which if it is collagated together, it forms the tumor. And as I am not the medical expert, so I cannot comment on that. But as per my experience with the working with the different surgeons is concerned, so the 3D printing is used for printing of the tumor at its original size, so that the surgeons can take a decision for which portion to be operated and how it is to be operated. So to answer it, the 3D printing cannot detect the cancer. Yeah.
Okay. One more question from Ashish Karigar, I guess. Yes. Which material is used for 3D printing as an organ on which doctors work pre-surgery?
It's a rubber. So rubber or it's a plastic parts. So it has a non-linear characteristics. So there are different grades of rubbers are there, which are flexible. So, and if at all, because as soon as you use the nylon 66 or plastic part, it hardens after a few days. So we need to add the additives inside of that so that there is a flexibility there. So it's a rubber or rubberized materials are used. Yeah, for the trials.
Okay, any other questions? You can directly ask.
Yes, sir. Good evening, sir. I am Abhigyan Ranjan from first year mechatronics.
Good evening.
So I wanted to know that I studied somewhere about additive manufacturing.
Yes.
So is there any difference from 3D printing to that of additive manufacturing?
No, it is same. One and the same.
See,
yes. So additive manufacturing means what? See, earlier technology was wherein which you carve out the material. So as you are in the first year engineering, when you will do the workshop, so in the workshop, you will see that on the lathe machine, you are removing the material. So instead of removing the material, here in this case, you are adding the material layer by layer wise. And that is the reason why it is called as additive manufacturing. So additive manufacturing and 3D printing is one and the same as a terminology wise is concerned.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.
Yeah. One more question from Adnan again. Can we use 3D printing technology for making electronic components like microcontroller? Very good question, I guess.
I think I'm not the right person to answer that. So because some couple of my friends, they work into that, into the area of 3D printing of electronics, but I'm not aware of it.
Okay, sir. Yes, one question from Yashraj.
Yes.
Can any material be used for 3D printing? The question we are not getting, Yashraj. You can directly ask what you want to ask. Mean. Yes, Yashraj, are you there?
Yes, sir. This is Yashraj.
Yes.
Yes. The question is, can any type of material can be used as a feed in the 3D printer?
No. Answer is no. See, specifically because the material, it needs to have a viscosity. So viscosity means it should flow. So there are different materials are there when it, where in which, so in the, it depends on the process. I'll say that if you read the basics of that, so you'll have the more idea. One of the material is, it is in the format of powder. So after heating it, it solidifies. So that is one kind of material which comes under the SLS process. The another type of the material is there at certain temperature, it is into the liquid format. So, and at it, once you apply the heat to that, it solidifies. So that particular process comes under the SLA. And the third one is with where in which the material itself is in the solid wire format. And after heating it, it converts into the glue and then it solidifies. Those come under the FDM process. So to answer your question, is all materials can be used for the 3D printing? Then answer is no. So there are still selective materials are there, and the researchers are already working out that how each material can be converted into the 3D printed material. Yeah. So right now there are limitations. So there are only few materials are there which you can use it for the 3D printing.
Okay.
Yes. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
One more question from Anmol Sehgal. Is it necessary to use the voxelizer in 3D printer to use STL file formats?
No. Answer is no. Voxelizer, you see, voxelizing means what? Basically, you are converting everything into a cuboid structure. That is called as a voxel. Voxel program is there. But it is not mandatory. It is optional. So if you want to tweak the geometry, or if you really want to see the staircase effect, in that case, the voxelization method you can use. But it is not mandatory. It is optional.
Yes, any more questions, students? I guess no questions. Yes. Okay, sir. Today's session is really helpful for understanding the scope of this 3D printing technology, and it is helpful to explore the career options in this particular field.
Yeah.
So, just from out of curiosity, I want to ask, if you, the students are interested in this particular domain, then yes, how they should proceed to acquire the skills and what are the resources available for this?
Yeah, basically, I'll say that in the generally in the colleges, so they get the chance to work on the 3D printing. So in your college, I think I have spoken with the Dipti madam. So one of the quick thing is that you can buy the 3D printer as a FDM process so that students can are aware of it. If not, then there are different government labs are there. So some of the labs which I know, I can share you the names of that so that you can send your students there and they can see the actual 3D printing and how it is carried out. So they have a different slots are there. So they can visit there and see the printing, and then they get the feel of that. So, and the government programs are for free. So only thing is they need to give the slot, and at that slot, they need to visit there. Yeah.
Okay, so it is really important to information that we got that there are government labs for this 3D printing technology.
Yes, okay. Correct. I'll share you though some of the information.
Yeah, definitely.
Correct.
So sir,
correct.
I thanks for accepting our invitation and sharing valuable information with our students.
Yes. Yeah, and I am also thankful to you and your all the students for participating and attending this webinar. And I don't know how many of them are really sleeping, but assuming that there none of them is sleeping, so let's hope that they will enjoy and they can look at the 3D printing as a one of the career option, further life. Yeah, so let's hope that. And if they have any other further questions, you can divert them to me directly. So I'll definitely answer them. Yeah, for sure. I'll try my best.
Yes, sir. We will be in contact with you for the, if we need any help from you in the particular, this field.
Yeah, sure. Okay.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much, sir. It was a really informative session. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks a lot.